We're going to have the electrodes on all five of your major muscle groups in your leg so that it can provide stimulation to them.
So what's that major muscle group down there?
This is the anterior tibialis. It helps to dorsiflex your foot, so it helps to bring your foot up off of the ground. Okay. This is your gastroc. So you can push off through your toes when you're walking.
Otherwise known as calf.
Yes. So now I'm gonna attach the wires to all of the muscles that are gonna be stimulated. And this is so that this cable will talk to the computer and it will fire the muscles at the right time during the gait cycle. So that to simulate walking as if your muscles were working the way they had prior to the stroke. So this is providing body weight support so that as you start to get better contractions in your muscles, that you'll be able to take more of your own body weight while being up on the stepper in order to simulate walking over ground when you would take your whole body weight. Putting Britta's personal ID number into the system, 1270. So it has all of her settings downloaded and saved. So we're gonna connect the harness to the hoist. Right. Ready to fly?
Fly like your man.
Yep.
That's good. 3 seconds, I get to feel like I'm on Broadway.
Over. We're gonna hook up the hip guides, so we kind of give Britta 4 additional points of support to prevent her from doing too much side to side or lateral sway or too much front to back sway. And it helps to keep her posture in place because now she's walking without an assistive device. So she'll be able to get that reciprocal arm swing. So you don't want them too tight where it holds the patient where they're not moving at all, but you don't want it too loose where she would be kind of all over the place. So right now you're not gonna feel any stim, but the speed of the stepper is gonna start to pick up. So this is our warm-up phase, which is for about 2 minutes, just getting your body used to being upright in the harness, having weight going through your legs. All right, I want you to make sure on your left leg, when your leg is right underneath, you want to have your knee fully extended.
Is my right leg coming close to hyperextending?
Nope. All right, so in a couple of seconds, you're going to start to feel this stim start to turn up. Then your stimulation levels have all been set to what you tolerate the most and where you get the best contraction. You've seen that the right hamstring, the front of the right thigh, is where you get the best contraction. So that's kind of where we see the most response to the stim. The rest of the 5 muscle groups all are kind of at a sensory level for you, where you feel it, but we're not getting a strong contraction yet. But you're able to tolerate a lot more of that than you used to when we first started using stim. Your posture looks very good. I want you to try to incorporate that right arm more into the arm swing. So you've got reciprocal arm swing going with your leg. Right arm moves with the left leg, left arm moves with the right leg.
Like this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And this is different than how you do walking on the ground because you don't have, in the cane, your right, it doesn't move at the same time as your right leg. It's kind of like a pseudo reciprocal.
It's amazing what was so natural before my stroke takes a lot of thought and concentration.
Yeah.
Now, you know, I'm like left arm, right arm, you know, left leg, right arm, you know? Left leg, right arm, right, left arm, right leg, you know? Mm-hmm.
The neural pathways are not there, right? The connections, but your connections keep changing, keep regenerating. Improving, working hard at it. Stim is all the way up to the level it's going to stay at. You can feel on the quad, we're getting a good contraction. I'm going to hit you continue focusing on that arm swing, moving your head up. You can see that your weight is shifting by the handlebars, going a little bit right to left, but that's normal when we walk. It's not that there's an asymmetry significantly to one side or the other. And your weight bearing is improving as we're going.
The handlebars, I didn't even notice them because it's black on black. Handlebars on the black asphalt, so I didn't even notice them.
Yeah, and it tells you the distance we've gone in yards.
Yeah, that I noticed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And your weight bearing is going up, so you're now doing 78% of the work. But in only 20, and this is actually the best that you've done. When we first started on this, you were only able to do 17 minutes, two minutes of the warm up, and then the 15 right. minutes of the stimulation, the actual stepping. But now, that's generally what we do with patients when we first start on. You don't want to overtax the nervous system.
Right.
And a lot of times we have patients who aren't used to upright being on here. You happen to be one of our ambulators, so it's a little bit different with you, but this fatigue factor still can kick in. But now, the last session, I think we were up to 27 or 28 minutes. So you're tolerating a longer time being on here, getting more stimulation and more of that reciprocal patterning that, trying to send signals up to your central pattern generators, because this is something your body does inherently. You have to, like you said, you didn't used to have to think about it. So we're trying to, give input to your brain that, okay, we don't nearly have to think about it. We can just do it. Good job, keeping your head up, looking straight ahead.
Just their new shoes.
Good. I haven't broken in yet. Okay, good job.